welcome to my Fenix Furia stream. Setting things up here, so it'll be a moment. This is Fenix Furia. It is a old school 2D platformer by Green Lava Studios. I heard it was similar to Jump Jet Rex. That's really about it as far as what I know. So let's get right into it. Well, these might be the world selects. Don't know what these modes mean. One moment. Okay. Tell me what I have to do to unlock that. Guess I'll just do it on rage mode. Faster. Nope, that's not how. Okay, probably can't beat it. One moment. Are you there? Can you hear me okay? Because the music's really loud. I tried turning it down, but I don't know if I did a good enough job with that. Seems good. Okay. I died. Wait, where do I go? Oh, he's up there. I turn... No, I cannot. I think I'm gonna turn it down a bit more. There we go. I was having a hard time hearing you, too, so... I guess that means it's a little too loud? Yeah. Ah, you can if you want. If you... Yeah, okay, I didn't think of that.
What does that mean? All right.
Oh, it shows where he's at. Ow. So to anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia, developed by Green Lava Studios. It is a retro-inspired 2D platformer, although there's really not that much platforming, so I don't know how accurate that is. Ow. Kind of seems like a Rage game, too, with the whole instant death thing, instead of, like, Super Meat Boy, where you'll probably die a lot, but, like, since it throws you back into it so quickly, doesn't feel terrible. Not really a punishing game, just a game that kind of lives off that.
Well, it's not punishing yet. Let's say that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's probably accurate. So far, this has been pretty easy for the most part, other than me just, like, continuously touching those enemies. Oh, I got an achievement. Warming up. Died 10 times. Well, that'll be more to come. Trying to get all the cookies. I don't know if there's any incentives to doing it other than an achievement. I'm going to try anyway. Crap. Having a really hard time getting back up there again, though. Really, as far as the timer goes, there's no punishment for taking too long. I think it's probably there solely for just, like, people who like getting good spots on leaderboards. Oh, that put me on fire. I wonder if that lets me melt ice blocks and kill enemies, or just melt ice blocks. Different mechanic, though. Let's test that Fury. Okay, definitely don't kill enemies when on fire. Crap. A little floaty. Have to get used to that. Anything up here? No.
Oh, you know what? I just realized you were on fire to break those, the blocks at the bottom of that. They look like they're ice.
Yeah. Yeah, that's probably what it's for. What the heck is that, an 11 block? Wow, a lot of enemies. Crap. I really like the art style of this. Wait, what did that say? Did that change to 10? What is that? Oh, is that like a warp zone or something? Oh, I bet that's a warp zone. I hate to, like, make another comparison to Super Meat Boy, but... In that, oh, crap. In Super Meat Boy, there was warp zones. Oh, got another achievement. fell off the map. Okay. In Super Meat Boy, there was warp zones where they had a timer to them, so you only had like a certain amount of time to get to them. But they would have like a interesting secret like level you could play. Granted, I have no idea this will be the same thing, but I desperately want to get to it now. But I feel like that's causing some unnecessary deaths on my part by rushing. Oh, there we go, finally I made it. Crap. To anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a retro-inspired 2D platformer. It is developed by Green Lava Studios. And you can get it now on the marketplace for, I think, $11. I think it has a discount for this week. Either $11 or $12, somewhere around there. Crap.
It'll be $11.99 on sale from a regular $15.
Ah, well, I took too long to get to that. I think I'll worry about that thing later and just try to beat the level. Did really pique my interest, though, but it is kind of hard to get to. You know what? Oh, crap. Try to get to it without paying attention to the cookie. Nope, that's not how you do that. Crap. That goes away fast. Yeah, I'll worry about that later. Either way, when you're not rushing, there's a good chance you'll die. It's just kind of a matter of getting used to the controls, I guess.
Bless you.
I do have my chat pulled away, so you'll have to keep me posted on uptimes and whatnot.
Your sneeze knocked your headset away from your face a little bit. You're a little quiet.
Is that better?
A little closer.
How about now?
Yes, much better.
I always forget it does that.
And that's what the mod is here for.
Crap. Oh, I swear I'm good at video games, I swear. Crap, I'm not jumping over that correctly. Not dying would help too. Crap. I guess we'll just take the other way around, because that is not working for me. Now to anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a 2D retro-inspired platform developed by Green Lava Studios. And it is also kind of a rage game. Maybe not even kind of, it could just be 100% intentionally a rage game. Is a bit reminiscent of Super Meat Boy with how the death in-game works. Oh yeah, that is way easier. Instead of dying though, that helped.
Ugh, the rage is real. I can feel it's coming.
Wait till you play Color Symphony.
Crap.
Oh, you played that yesterday, didn't you?
No, I did not. I booted it up to do a sound check on it, but I haven't actually played it yet. Okay, I got the cookie. Oh, wait. Yeah, I have to go down now. Crap. Oh, no! There was a guy there. I didn't think I'd be stuck on one level for this long, but that's what's happening.
And you lost that cookie, too, whenever you die, don't you?
Yep.
Just thought of that.
I don't think there's an incentive to getting the cookies, but I just want to get them. If it gets too irritating, I'll stop. Just progress through the level, but... Or attempt to progress through the level, I guess. But for now, I do want to get them. To anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a retro-inspired 2D platformer developed by Green Lava Studios. Available now on the marketplace for $11.99 for this week. That'll be $15 after that. Ah, hesitated again.
You're probably close to the not sure if achievement. You're dying 100 times in one level.
I was actually thinking that too. Pretty bad that I'm doing that unintentionally. But I did just beat the level, so hooray for that. Oh, this looks worse. Maybe. Where the heck is the cookie at? There. Ow.
So you died 44 times in that last level.
Oh, I did? I didn't even notice.
Yes.
There's the cookie.
So, it's gotta be what it is. When you beat the level, there's the three blocks in the middle, and it'll tell you if you got the golden cookie.
Crap.
On the right one. On the left one, it has, I believe it's Dead Fenix? What's his name? Undead, Dead Fenix, something like that.
I don't really know if he has a name. The game's called Fenix Furia, but...
Well, no, there's another Fenix, like I believe he's Fenix. The character you play with the blue and the yellow, the Sonic-looking guy. His name is Fenix, but there's an undead version of him.
Oh, there we go, that was
where
hard.
He looks like he's bone.
It'd just be like the kill counter thing.
I thought he was a unique character for the console release.
Oh, I have no idea. Wow, this is a very straightforward level. Oop. Doesn't mean I won't die though. anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a retro-inspired 2D platformer developed by Green Lava Studios. You can buy it now for $11.99 for probably this week, and then it'll be $15 after that. And it's kind of a rage game, but not in a bad way, though. It actually works pretty well. Oh god, the cookie's over there. Crap, that's hard. Crap. I wonder if I imposed a insane challenge on myself by wanting to get these cookies. Starting to question that now. Oh, I could just go over him. I didn't even think of that. There we go. Ooh, I hesitated there. That almost killed me. This is a big level. But I have to go this way to get the cookie. Yep. I was correct in that assumption. Crap. Oop. I need to stop doing that. Oh, there's another warp zone thing here too. Where the heck that's at? Super Meat Boy had something similar to these cookies as well. It had bandages.
Well, and didn't also, what was that other game? I believe it was a Behemoth game. Had Hatsy in it. I'm just drawing the massive blank. What was that game?
Something similar to this?
Yeah, there was, a lot of platforming, jumping, oh lord.
Battle Block Theater, maybe?
Battle Block Theater, yeah. It had collectibles like that. What were they? Birthday cakes?
No, that was Explosion Man.
Oh, you know what? Explosion Man's also another game similar to that.
Yes. Battle Block Theater had, had prisoners, but I don't remember how you went about getting them, though.
Was it Balls of Yarn?
I remember the bug. Yeah, it was Balls of Yarn, because that was like their currency. Okay, I'm approaching this wrong. I'm just not being fast enough. Oh, well, that was too fast. Crap. Screwed that up. And that.
So you said it earlier. I have to agree. I really like the art.
I did too.
I like the way everything it looks.
I can't really make a comparison for some reason. Like I can't think of anything right now that it reminds me of. That may be because there isn't anything I can think of that it reminds me of.
Kind of reminds me of an old cartoon,
like an 80s like cartoon.
Like late 80s, early 90s. I guess it's the clouds. The clouds in the background are what really give me that feeling.
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely like it.
Can you check how many times you've died in a level?
Not via the main menu, I can't. I definitely died here a lot, too. Trying to get the stupid cookie.
You have.
Oh, wow, that was way easier. I should have went that route a long time ago. Ooh. That was good for my part, though. I don't know why I didn't do that before. I think he's up somewhere. Yep, there he is. Whew, that was close. 21 times for this level. Oh gosh. Oops. Apparently,
there's
why
nowhere near as many
restart
times as about half amount. You said 21.
Yeah.
Yeah, 21. That, the one level you were stuck on earlier, you had 44 deaths.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
This looks like a nightmare.
Not really. If I could just scoot up on the top. Oop, got another achievement. Get used to this. Died 100 times. Oh, goody. Crap. Although, like, the kill box is right there, so that's a little iffy. If anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a retro-inspired 2D platformer. Oops. Developed by Green Lava Studios. Available now in the marketplace for $11.99 on sale. Then it'll be $15 after the sale. It is also a rage game reminiscent of Super Meat Boy. Okay, maybe I won't do the top route. Crap. Maybe I will do the top route. He's right over there. Oh, I was not paying attention. Oop, jumped too high that time. That's a good spot, I guess. Crap. Didn't pay attention to that one. Anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a 2D retro-inspired platformer developed by Green Lava Studios. Buy it now in the marketplace for $11.99. It'll be $15 after that sale. Crap. Up now I'm just pointlessly dying. Top route seemed like the best route, but that kill box is such a pain. Crap. Yeah, bottom looks equally as hard. Definitely getting harder, that's for sure. Can I get a uptime mod?
Alright, where'd I leave my keyboard? There it is.
Crap, too close.
31 and a half minutes.
Safe spot in the middle there. Where did I go? That was weird. I'll try the top again. Yep, then jump high enough. Exact thing that time.
Should be a verbal word count. How many times has how many times has he said crap?
Well, at least I'm keeping it a family friendly stream. I know most people would say something else.
I've cursed before in my stream, so I apologize. I'm that guy.
Which is fine.
Different strokes for different folks? Question mark? Sark mark?
How am I gonna do this? Yep, that's a good way. There we go, I just don't dash like a crazy person. Oh no, I hit it. Oh, that was stupid. That kill box, though. There is a easy mode, but I didn't really want to do, like, not the default mode for this.
Does the easy mode remove the ability to earn achievements?
See, I did not know that. But you know what? Now that you mention it, let me back out.
Probably, though, right? Because,
give it a thing.
What was, there was a game we played recently. There was an easy, was it Super Knight Riders?
Oh.
Did Super Knight Riders do that? The easy race mode, removed achievements?
Yeah, it did. But, it, that's what the difference is. It specifically mentioned that, it removed achievements or disabled achievements. I don't want to risk like not getting achievements, so I'm going to go back to normal. But basically, that adds like a life kind of that lets you get hit once before you actually die. Guess I'll try out two modes just to show everybody like, oh, this is just. Okay, this is local co-op mode. Well, never mind. We are not showing that. Back to rage mode. Oh, you know what? It may affect what kind of cookie you get. I just noticed there's, like, a different cookie shown on the icon there. So that's something. And who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a 2D retro-inspired platformer developed by Green Lava Studios. And it is on the marketplace now for $11.99. It'll be on sale for this week, and then it'll be $15 afterwards. Crap, missed that jump. It's also a rage game. Not a bad thing, but I know that can be hit or miss for some people. If you like games like Super Meat Boy or 1001 Spikes, which I still have to play the new version of that. I don't know if I ever will. Then this game would be the game for you. I'm pretty impressed with it. Definitely gets pretty hard pretty quickly, though. Wouldn't be something I could play, like, long play sessions with. Oh, crap, I fell off. Jump down and then dash across. Oop. Should be good. Oh gosh. Did it finally, but that could have been a lot worse.
How many deaths was that?
9 because I quit out, so it did not count my initial death count.
Oops. Now, we were talking about this earlier, the undead skin. When you went into co-op, I noticed player 2 was rocking that skin that I was talking about.
Oh, you know what? He was. That's right. Didn't even realize that until you said it. Crap. Yeah, they may just not have had local co-op when the game originally came out, because I know there was a version before this, and it may even have, like, a different title.
I believe that game was actually Fenix Rage.
Oh no, that was what they were originally going to call it before they had to change the name.
I thought it came out on, I thought it had an alpha build, either something Steam related or something like that.
I don't know, like... I feel like it was called something else originally, but I may be wrong. Ooh, that's fast. Crap, ran right into the other one. Anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a 2D retro-inspired platformer developed by Green Lava Studios. It is $11.99 on the marketplace now. It'll be $15 probably after the week is over, which is its default price. And it is also a very rage-heavy game. So, if you like games like Super Meat Boy or 1001 Spikes, this would be right up your alley. But if you don't like it, then you may not like the game. Don't know.
I would avoid it.
You wouldn't like it?
I mean, if you don't like rage games, I probably wouldn't, if I were you.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, we've reached 40 plus on the death counter on some of these levels.
Yeah, that's true. Ooh, finally. There's a 10 death count for that. Ooh, cutscene. What the heck? Oh no, he zapped it. Oh. Oh no. Oh, terrible. Oh, I'm dead.
There is an achievement for getting behind him.
Getting behind him?
Yes. I believe it's called check behind your butt. Or something along those lines.
I'm not sure how I would get behind him unless I just, like, hug. No? That was weird.
Maybe if you were to jump in the top corner of one of the areas. Oh, he slams you.
Yeah, it seems like whatever corner I hide in, he gets me.
Let me double check that. Let me go and check that.
Oh no!
Look behind your butt. Get behind Bur, B-U-E-R. I'm not sure. But that is definitely this little guy.
Oh, I keep pressing X on accident, and that is messing me up terribly. So terrible of them to put a cookie right there.
Monsters.
It just automatically cuts down the time you have to, like, run from this guy. Oop, I screwed that up already. Oops. Did not mean to do that either. Oh, I should have dashed. What was I doing? I don't know what to do with that. I can't dash down. Oh my. Oh yeah, I've already screwed this up. How do I get behind him? That would actually be helpful now. Wow.
Yeah, don't really have an answer on how you would get behind him.
Can I get an uptime mod?
Yes.
Crap.
Yeah. 45 minutes.
Okay.
Could you get behind him? I'm trying to think of the best place to...
I can't break the ice. I'm fairly confident I can.
Oh, you know what? You might be able to get... So the ice where you have to travel forward, jump up, travel back toward him, and then travel forward again. There's a ledge, like there's a lift there. Could you jump up into that corner to get behind him?
Wow, I do not know what to do with that.
It'll be on that third level, like the third one down. You know what I'm talking about?
Say that again.
So the third level down, when you drop down, there's the checkered ice blocks.
Yep.
That it has a ledge, like right past the checkered parts where you're supposed to jump through the S shape to get to the other side. That port or that area has a little spot lifted up. Could you hide up there as he passed past you? Like jumped up into that corner.
Oh, maybe. Yeah, I see what you're talking about. Oh, I do not think so. Unless I just didn't jump enough. I think he can still get me from that. Crap. That time I know I didn't jump high enough. Maybe the left corner? Oh, I did it!
Oh, is that where it was?
Yeah, it was the left corner. That made everything so much easier, too. Wow. What's that? Into the cookies. Collected all cookies from Red Forest. Oh, cool. Ooh, another cutscene.
It looked like a biscuit with, like, jam on it.
Oh my god, this guy's terrible. Oh, a nice level. Or a nice world, I guess. Let me go back real quick. I wonder now if I beat this world. Nope, those other two modes are still locked. It was worth a check.
He kind of reminds me of Eggman, just taking simple, cute little things and just being like, you know what? Make that terrible.
He reminds me of Dr. Robotnik and Meta Knight. Like, I get like a Meta Knight vibe from him, too.
Yeah. He kind of looks like Meta Knight.
Oops, I did not mean to beat that level without the cookie. Let me go back and get that. Yeah, like, he looks like Meta Knight, and... kind of, like, evil, but you don't really know why he's evil kind of thing.
Did somebody say Meta Knight?
Just definitely a Meta Knight vibe. And robotic.
I'm a bad guy, because reasons.
Or no. I guess he's technically not a bad guy, but, what's the guy from Mega Man? Zero?
Oh. Yeah. The guy in the red armor.
Yeah, the red armor.
Yeah.
Kind of like Mega that, Man. Too. In fact, that's probably a trope now that I think about it.
Not really bad, I'm just kind of not that great.
Yeah, not a bad trope, but just a trope. That's something. For some reason, I thought I could break through that. Anyone who's joining in, this is Fenix Furia. It is a 2D retro-inspired platformer developed by Green Lava Studios. You can buy it now for $11.99, and it'll be $15 after the weekly sale. It's also a very rage-heavy game, which is not really a bad thing, but kind of a niche thing for a lot of people. Either like those kind of games like Super Meat Boy or 1001 Spikes, or you don't. Me, personally, I like them in moderation. I can't marathon them, but I really enjoyed Super Meat Boy and I played the original 1000 Spikes game, but I have not played the new one on Xbox One yet. I don't know if I ever will. Crap. Can I get a another uptime mod?
Hi. 52 minutes. Got about 8 minutes left.
I really like the art style. I wish I had a nice, like, descriptive word for it, but I don't think really pixelated matches it any. Not cel-shaded, like, I don't really know what you could call it, but it's nice. I like it. Crap. For anybody who doesn't like being timed, that timer you see on the top right of the screen really doesn't have any kind of penalty to it. Like, I think its pretty much main point of existence is for people who like getting high spots on leaderboards. Crap. I should go the other way. It does have a local co-op mode, but unfortunately I won't be able to try that out. And it has an easy mode, but I don't know if it disables achievements. And really the only difference between it and the regular rage mode is you have like a life, sort of, where you take one extra hit.
Something akin to, like, the one-up in Mario.
Not even like that. I would even say it's more like a ring from Sonic. Like, just getting a single ring.
Yeah, the rings. The tiki face from Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah. Well, that goes really fast. There he is, right over there. Crap. Okay, you know what? Let's quit out of this. Do you want to look at something? Oh my gosh! It's ingredients on how to make a specific kind of cookie, and directions. I had a feeling that there was something up with that. I didn't even remotely expect it would be like...
That's pretty amazing.
How to make a specific kind of cookie. I've only seen this in one other game, and that was hashtag iDarb. When you would get achievements in hashtag iDarb, you would get recipes for different kinds of food. Wow, that is actually really cool. I like that. Oh, here's a stat option. Total deaths, 159. Game completion, 4.67. 21 out of 180 cookies. 22 levels beat. What are the stars?
They might be a harder difficulty. They might replace the cookies.
Could be, or it could have something to do with the timer. Sorry about that.
I do know that there are achievements for collecting stars from different areas, like...
Oh, there is an arcade mode. What is this?
So, three achievements,
Fenix's box.
There's two achievements that really make me think that they're modes, because it says collect all red stars on challenge mode, and then collect all blue stars on god mode.
Oh, so those would be the other two modes that are locked.
Aye.
But there's yellow stars, though.
I believe those are time trial stars.
Let's see. Try getting, like, the best time on the first level. Yeah. That's exactly what it is. It's time trial.
Is that what it was? Okay.
Yeah. So there is an incentive to, like, beating the... are being fast, you get stars, which unlocks something in arcade mode, which who knows what that is. Other than, like, possible mini-games. Let's try to see if I get five real quick before I end the stream.
We're also sitting at 58 minutes.
Yeah, I figured I was close. Ooh, that is not fast enough. Right on the dock.
So, the timer, I had noticed this earlier. I didn't pay much attention to it. But the timer at the top right stays white when you are under the best time. Once you go over the best time, it turns red, so letting you know you're not going to get
stars.
That.
Yes, which is very helpful. Oh, there we go. Wait a minute. What is this? Wow.
So you spin the stars to unlock to actually unlock the game itself.
I'm not sure what it meant by spin. But yeah, that's what it looked like. I am doing terrible at this. Oop, and game over. Alright, well, that's a look at one of the mini games. And there's also this Fenix box mode, but... Yes, that's what those red cubes were that I saw earlier, but they are hard to get. I'm not going to attempt that in the few, like, minute or seconds I have left in the stream, but this was Fenix Furia, 2D retro-inspired platformer developed by Green Lava Studios. It is available now for $11.99, and then it'll be $15 after the week sale. It is a rage-heavy game, so if you like rage platformers like Super Meat Boy or 1001 Spikes, this game would totally be for you. If not, then you probably wouldn't like this. That's all for now, and tune in later tonight for a stream of Color Symphony 2. Goodbye.